In this video, we take a look at how to design a makeup class flyer like this in Photoshop. And this is coming up. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel once again. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So here are the resources that I'll be using. A link to download them will be in the description if you want to download and follow suit. Now let's get into Photoshop and let's get started. First of all, we're going to create this on an A3 paper. So we go to file and then new, and you're going to set an A3 paper. So what you do is you go to presets here, international paper, and then it should have your size over here. Click on it and choose A3. Now you go ahead and then you click OK. So the first thing that we're going to add is a gradient. You know, I'm a guy of gradients, right? So gradients pack, and then you're going to choose our gradient, and you click on the gradient fill over here and you can choose your gradient. I've already set the gradient to make it very easier for you. So I'm going to select the first color, which is this one, if you want to copy that. And then the second color is going to be this one, if you want to copy that. You go ahead and then we click OK. Now at the end of the video, we're just going to try it with a different color and see how it actually turns out. So you click OK. Over here, I'm going to change my style to radial. My angle remains 90 and I'm going to scale this up to about 130. Now with this, you can use your pointer and then drag it to any part of it that you want it. So you can change the location right from here if you can see what exactly I'm doing. So I want to place it at the extreme right top and I'm going to leave it over there, and from there we can go ahead and click OK. Now the next thing that we do is when you go to our resource file, we have a couple of backgrounds here. I intentionally downloaded this for you so you can use any one of them that looks perfect for you. But what worked best for me was this one, so you can try yours and let me know the results by posting on social media. So you drag and drop it inside of Photoshop here, and what you're going to do is you're going to open it up or scale it up, and then you can position it on top over here. From there we go ahead and right click, rasterize, and you can see from here that if you zoom in, this particular image looks way blurry, and that is because the resolution is not that high. So we try to get like higher resolutions, but since this is going to be a background, it wouldn't be that much of a problem. So the next thing is you press shift control and then U to desaturate this, and then you're going to change the blend mode to soft light. So as I said, because it is going to be a background, even if you try to scale it up a bit, you'll not really see it that much. Now we don't want the edge to be this very straight, so we add a layer mask to it, choose the brush tool, and then you can open it up. Make sure that the foreground color is black, and you can use X to switch it up like that, and you can then brush this one off to make it blend with the background. Now we want to add our image to it, so let's go to view here and add a new guideline. The new guideline is going to help us to position our text and then the images very correctly. So what we do is we're going to type 50% over here. That's, we are dividing the paper into two equal parts. From there we go to the ellipse here, we pick the ellipse tool, and we want to position the image over here. You realize that the image is quite very small, so you're going to create a circle over here. So you hold shift and then you create your circle, something perfect like that. You hold shift because you want to get a perfect circle. Afterwards, I make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, press Ctrl T, and I'm going to transform that a little bit like this. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to double click over here and change the color to white, and for the ellipse at the bottom, I'm going to change the opacity to 30%. So you can drag this, or perhaps you can use your numeric key to set it to 30. Now we go back to the ellipse on top here, and that is what we're going to place the image inside of it. So we go into our resource file, we have our image here, we will then drag it inside of Photoshop, and we have to place it on top of this ellipse because that's where we are actually placing it. Because the background is already taken off, you don't need to really do any other thing. So you right click on it and you go to create clipping mask. Now you take your time to position it, so you can press Ctrl T to transform it out a bit or even make it a bit bigger like that, and then you can take your time to position it. Now once this is ready, we then go in and bring in our logo, and this logo was submitted by the client. Please don't come at me. So you drag the logo also into Photoshop, and we want to place it at the extreme top left over here, and you double click on it, and that is the name of the person, or that is the company of the person organizing the program. And before we continue, I want to pass out this, that this is a free makeup training that is going to be held by this particular company. If you are somebody who wants to get into makeup, or you want to learn and you are interested, you can follow or call the numbers. So you take your time and then you position it right over there, and we are good to go. Now the rest is going to be our test and the rest of the information that we need to put on this one. So let me set up another guideline over here that we're going to use to keep the test also in alignment. You know, the alignment is very important when you are considering flyer making. And then we can go for the test tool, and we're going to first make use of our lovely brother Poppins. Okay, so Poppins and bold, and we're going to the resource here. I've already typed the test, and we're going to copy that 5 days intensive and paste it over here. So I'm going to change the color to white and click OK. I'll then go ahead and press Ctrl T to transform it out to be a bit bigger like that. Now it is too bold for me, so we're going to change this one to semi bold, and that looks good. Now we make sure that this is in the left alignment, because you want to keep it aligned to this particular grid line that we set. Okay, so once you're done with that, you can push it to the very end of the grid line, and when you zoom in, you can see that it is at the very end. You can push it a bit more, and you can see that it is at the very end. And from there, we can make a duplicate of this particular 5 days intensive by pressing Ctrl J, and we can drag it over here. Now when you go into the test, you have another test. I'm going to speed up a bit because here is the test part, and probably you know how we do about test, right? So we're going to copy the first one, which is makeup, and we're going to select this one, paste it over here, and we're going to open that one up because that is the main subject. Okay, so we're going to open this one up to be a bit bigger. Now I feel like this looks way big for me, so I'm just going to select both of them and try to close it up a bit here like that, and we can actually close this one as well. And what we do next is we're going to change the color of this. So we check the color here, and we're going to set it something quite dark yellow. Okay, so something like this one would do, and we click OK. So after that, you can right click on this one, go to the blending options, and then we can add a bit of drop shadow. So we turn up the drop shadow and you increase the size like that so that the yellow can be seen. So the next thing that we do is we're going to make another duplicate of the makeup here. So Ctrl J, and we can drag it to the very bottom over here. So you take time and you make sure that the spaces between them are also even, and then you come back to this makeup that you copied. You're going to change the color back to white, and you go into your test over here, and you can copy this class. So 5 days intensive makeup class. Okay, so class over there, and the class is a bit smaller, so you're just going to press Ctrl T and transform it out so that it can be on the same side. Now you see how aligned it is, aligned to the left, and that pretty much tells you that using the guidelines makes things so easier for you. So this is how far we've come. So the next thing that we want to do is the topics that will be treated under the program or under the training. So let's open this one up a bit, and to do that, you're going to create a very simple rectangle. Okay, so let's group all of these ones and call it the main. Okay, so it's going to be the main subject. So from there, we can go for our rectangle tool over here, and we're going to create a rectangle, so something pretty much like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that we bring it down a bit. Now the next thing that we want to do is we want to decrease the opacity of this one. So we press 20 on our numeric key, or you can try 30, anyone that will be quite easier for you. Okay, and the next thing that we want to do is you right click on this one, go to the blending options, and then you can have your stroke over here. So we add a bit of stroke to it, change the color to white, and we can click OK. Now let's increase the size of the stroke a bit more, so something like that, I think this is too big. Okay, so I think this looks okay, and we can click OK from here. Right from there, what we're going to do is we're going to paste in our test. So if I go into my test here, I have the topics and then all these ones. So I'm going to select first off topics over here, but then I don't want to place it just at the top over there, just like that. So I'll add another rectangle over here. So, but make sure that when you're doing this, you don't hold shift as it is going to combine with the first rectangle that you created. So what I do is I'm going to open this particular layer thumbnail, and I'm going to select a color from here. So something quite darker like this to make sure that it blends. Let me go for this one and come down a bit like that, and I'll click OK from here. So I can then go for the test tool over here and I can paste it, and then I'll choose the move tool and I can move it over here, but it has to be on top of the rectangle, so right over there. Now if I zoom in over here, I should make my rectangle a bit smaller so that it fits the test, or I should open my test rather. So you open the test up here a bit like that so that it can fill the rectangle a little bit like that. And the next thing that we want to do is inside of the rectangle here, we want to add another set of tests. So I'll go for my test tool and I'm going to make a test here. Go and copy these tests. So these are the topics that will be treated under the program. So I'm going to paste it right over there. Now I don't want this in the semi bold, so I'm going to select this one and I'm going to choose medium. Let me increase the size a bit, so around 29 or 30 would do for me. And then the spacing is so horrible, so I can come into the toggle character and open up the leading somewhere around here like that, so that there will be a lot of space such that the design can actually breathe. Now the next thing that we want to do here is to bullet this particular topics, okay, to make it look quite nice. And to do that, you're going to pick the rectangle to make some small rectangle. So that is why we have to actually make the adjustment by opening it up to set the spacing first before you make this. If you are using this method, it's a bit rough because anytime you close up this particular testing, the spacing, you would have to readjust the bulleting. So what we do is we're going to make a very small rectangle like this one, and we're going to change the color to white. Okay, so change the color here to white, and we can actually push it up here. Now if you are in the version of 2018 2019 or let's say 2019 2020, you can easily use the spacing button to space this one evenly. But if you are still using an older version like myself, you use this custom method. So you press Ctrl J to make a duplicate, drag it over here, and your eye has to be very nice in order to help you out. And you select the both of them, make a duplicate again, and then you can drag this one here as well, and then you can select the last one from here and you can make a duplicate and drag it over here. So you've bulleted your points very beautifully. Now let's go ahead and select all of these and group this one and call it the rec. Okay, so something like a rectangle. Okay, so that it wouldn't be that much of a problem. And from there we can select it plus the topic, and then this rectangle plus this one, select it all and name this one topics. And right after this, all that we're going to add will be the information concerning the program. So the date, the venue, the time, and all that, we're going to add it right away. And it's going to be test. So I'm going to be trying to fast forward some of this part. I don't want to keep this long. So we go for our test tool over here and we go into the test. We have this particular 23rd to 20. So this is an actual program that is coming on. If you are interested in learning makeup or whatsoever, you can hit up the numbers on this flyer and call them. It's for free. So the date is an important one. So let's try to open it up by pressing Ctrl T and opening it up like this. And we can press Ctrl A to make sure that it is centered, and then select all of this one because this color is not blending with the background well. So let's choose white instead. open it up some more because it is very important. The date is very, very important. If you like, you can add a bit of shadow to this one, but I don't like, so I'm not going to do that. And the next thing that I do is I'm going to add a time. So I'm going to create a rectangle over here, and I'm going to create this very small rectangle like that, and I'll make sure that I press Ctrl A and it's in the middle. So I make sure as well that I'll drag this, because we want to keep it left aligned, don't forget. So I'll make sure that I drag this to be at this point, and I can push it down a bit. Now let's go ahead and make a duplicate of this test, drag it on top of the rectangle, and it's not on top because it is underneath of the layer. So you send it up on the layer like this, open it up, and we're going to change the font from here. So you realize that we've been using poppins throughout, and you're going to switch to Acrobat because you're going to deal with a lot of other numbers. So let's change this one to semi bold, and we can go into our test here, select 130 or 1030 to 130. You can come here and edit that. So we want to put time here, or time in front of it, so the time will be here, and we can do that. So you press Ctrl A and then you make sure that it is centered as well. Press Ctrl T and transform it out a bit so that it can fit straight into the rectangle. The next thing that you do is you make another duplicate. So and from there, we can go ahead and add the icons to it. So let's go into the resource. We have this phone and WhatsApp icon here. The first one is the call icon. So I'll drag it inside of Photoshop and I'll put it at the extreme left. Now, if you want to get something like this, you can easily type call icon PNG and it's going to give you the one without a background. I'll try and make a dedicated video on that. So once you get it over here, you take your time and then you can position it over here. So if you want to call, you call this line. The black doesn't look good on the color over there, so you right click, rasterize, right click again and go to the blending options, and then you can add a color overlay to it. So we're going to change this one to white and you click okay. Now to make sure that the next icon that we bring in is in the same line, we're going to drag the grid over here to the very top, drag another one to the very bottom, and that means that our icon should be here. So that means we can go into our resources over here and we have the WhatsApp icon. For that, I didn't get a one without a background, so you drag it inside of Photoshop. You can choose any of these ones. The magic one is perfect for this, and you can make a selection over here, hold shift and make another selection, and then you select the white, as we are getting rid of all the whites in here as well. So when you're done, you hit delete and then you can delete this one. You can then right click, go to the blending options, and you can add your color overlay. So it's going to be white and okay from here. Now to make sure that this doesn't blur out, you're going to right click and convert it to a smart object, and you can send it into the document that you are working on. From here, you can easily press Ctrl T to transform it. And you see the reason why we had to add the guidelines. It has to be in there. So you press Ctrl T and make sure that it is at the very center of the guideline that we added. Now, the last test that we have will be at the very bottom here. And for that, you're going to use our final test. So we go into the test here and we're going to copy the terms and conditions applied. So when you call any terms and conditions, I don't know the terms also, when you call them any terms and conditions you discuss with them. I hope that sounds cool. And we're going to paste that. We're going to use our final font, which is Railway, and we're going to use the regular italic, or perhaps let's choose the medium italic, and we can press Ctrl T to transform this one out and make sure that it is centered in the middle. Now we are almost done with this design, but here looks so empty and plain, and fortunately we are left with one last test, so free tuition. So over here, what we want to do is we want to select the rectangle and create a very small rectangle over here, and you have to make sure that it is in alignment with this one as well. And from there, we can go into the test, copy that, and we can paste it right over here. So let's select a test for it, paste it, and we don't want to use the railway, so let's go back to poppins, because all the top is poppins, and we're going to use the semi bold over here. Now we keep it left aligned as well, and we can bring it over here, try and open it up or transform it to make it a bit bigger. Now what I want to do is I want to select the free from here and increase the font size so that it will be on the same edges with the tuition, and we can actually transform it a bit smaller, so something like this, and we can push it over here. Now what we do is we adjust the rectangle to fill it, and we can open it up over here like that. So let me just adjust it over here. So it is a free tuition. Like I said, if you are someone who is interested and you want to learn makeup for free, you can just hit them up. Now the last thing that we do is we select it all, change the color, and let's go for the yellow over here, and we click OK and OK from here. And right from here, when you select from the tuition to this very part, the date, you can group all of that and call it the info. So info over here like that, and then you can come back to your background, add a couple of curves to it. So let's add a slight bit of curve so that it can be a bit darker like that. And when you turn off the guidelines by pressing Control H, this is what we have. And that's pretty much for this video. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and also don't forget that this is a free tuition. The numbers are legit, just call them to know the location. If you're a bit closer to the location, you can go and study makeup for free. Thank you so much once again for sticking around to watch. Let me know your comments, let me know your thoughts, let me know your suggestions, and let me know your corrections in the comment section. I'll see you guys in the next video. It's Innocent here, and bye.